lot of chatter in this region involves nuclear material. You may remember from page 627 of my last report that there has been an uptick in KAOS interest in nukes. To wit, I offer the following conversation.
What are you doing? Are you texting?
Yeah, just letting my fiance know we won't be able to get married in June because we'll still be in this meeting.
Can I see that for a second?
Yeah.
That's great. Well, that's weird. We lost our signal. Sorry to interrupt, Maxie. Go ahead.
Next time, use your own damn phone.
Good morning, men. No offense, Karen. Snappy tie. Sorry I'm late, but I just came out of a budget meeting with our incredibly abrasive, dismissive, and sarcastic vice president.
It's no problem. I have obtained a snippet at great risk to a busboy in Balad. Aftab, how is your coffee? Good, Dalib. It's decaf. How is yours? It is good, also. How is your muffin? Powerful stuff.
So muffin, then, is a code word?
No, it is comfort food, and quite frankly, much more fattening than most people realize, which begs the question, why would two hardened KAOS agents risk the carbs? Because they are under a great deal of stress.
Hence the decaf.
For Aftab, yes, Dalip takes his full strength. Why? Because he has been sleeping on the couch for 3 days because he called his sister-in-law a leathery hag.
You know, people often say things in anger they don't really mean. Leathery hag, fat cow, ungrateful whore. Just words, really, that shouldn't be used against you in a custody hearing.
Let it go, man. Those kids don't even look like you.
Can we put a pin in this, please, and go back to Max's extraordinarily detailed report?
Thank you, Chief. All I'm saying is that until we understand that our enemies are also human beings, we will never be able to defeat them. Yes, they are bad guys, but that is what they do, not who they are. Let's continue listening and bear in mind that the next 100 pages can get a little bit dry.